I'm trying out one of these new microphones. Leave a message if you think the sound quality is improved from the previous videos. Welcome back to the Reflactor channel. I was recently contacted by a viewer named Mark who inherited an 8-inch Dobsonian telescope. Now, not just any Dobsonian telescope, he inherited an Orion XT8 Dobsonian telescope, which if you watched any of my previous videos, you'll know that's one of my favorite used telescopes. The only problem is that one of the previous owners of his telescope ran into problems with his Crayford focuser and attempted several fixes the wrong way. This one I'm holding is actually one of my Crayford focusers. This is what they look like, brand new. Unfortunately for Mark, all of those attempted fixes left his Crayford focuser in even worse shape. And by the time it got to him, there was actually a piece of PVC plumbing jammed into the focuser to be used as a makeshift adapter. Now, every once in a while, I get asked how to fix these, and I try to offer the best tips that I know, but at some point, sometimes it's just better to replace the whole thing. Orion would sell these for about $100, which is kind of interesting if you consider that this is one of the few spare parts that Orion would sell you if you were not the original telescope purchaser. Unfortunately, sometime over the past year or so, Orion stopped selling these new. That leaves only the used markets, like Cloudy Nights or Astromart or eBay. And even now, these are becoming scarce on those platforms as well. However, I've worked on a lot of these Crayford focusers over the years. After discussing it with Mark, I asked if I could take a crack at trying to fix his Crayford focuser. And that's what we're going to attempt to do in this video. Wish me luck. Here's the box. Let's go ahead and open it. So let's investigate the condition of this. Let's look at the tube. We have some paint that's missing on here. It's okay. I'm probably going to spray paint this with flat black. This has some interesting marks on it. I don't know if you can see that. So the Crayford focuser, if you've watched my video on the history of the Crayford focuser, it shows how it works. Basically, the axle here runs along this flat part, right? It just rolls along and pushes it. It's friction only. And on the opposite side, there are some roller bearings. Now, there is evidence here that this is actually rotated in this position. It should never rotate. It should be in here just so that the axle pushes on the flat part. So this has been rotating in here, and there's some flat parts put in there. I'll see if I can. I don't think there's really much to do other than just paint over those. So we'll go ahead and do that. One of the common things that's wrong with this is that the rubber grips have fallen off. This is super common. And I'm going to show you the really easy, cheap way that I use to fix those. I have a video dedicated to that, but I'm going to show it to you here anyway. This back panel is loose. It's missing one of the corner screws there. I'll see if I can find one of those. Those are metric. And it looks like the little bearing is still in place. That's good. The lock nut is missing. That's unfortunate. That's a five. I think this is a 3mm, and I think this is 5mm. And we'll see what we can do. But we're going to go in the order of catastrophic failure to easiest. And the main problem has to do with this part up here. This is the 2-inch adapter, right? This screws into there. It's supposed to screw into there. But unfortunately, over the years, these threads have been severely damaged. They've been either dropped or just hit and shredded. This is an M52 thread, I believe, either M52 or M54. I mean, in an ideal world, I would just get a thread die, put it on here, and just redo the threads, right? But you can't really do that. Now, they do make these big square files. They're called thread repair files that you can just run along here. And they're basically, they have a bunch of little sharp edges. And you run along the edge of a bolt. And it actually repairs the threads. And they work really, really well. But unfortunately, I don't think I can find one for something this large. And this is definitely... It is not going in there. So I think what I'll do is I have a little file that's very, very sharp, and I think I'm going to put it in here and just try to repair those threads. This will be the first thing that we try, because if we can't fix this, it may get a little bit tricky. In the past, I have purchased this part only, but I didn't purchase it from Orion. In fact, I purchased one just like this from Skywatcher. Skywatcher used to have a lot of parts very in common with Orion. And I think I paid $32. I don't know if they still sell this part, but worst comes to worst, we would do that. We would use this. And now there is no adapter from 2-inch to 1.5, but those are still available. Thank goodness. The owner, I think, has already ordered that, so that shouldn't be a problem. Also, he's missing these screws, the ones that hold the adapter in. But he did buy this, and this is a whole set of those knurled thumb screws. And I'm pretty sure these will work great in here, as long as this isn't stripped. If these holes are stripped, I'll just drill new ones. Won't be a problem. But he's got a bunch of these. We should be good to go on that. So first things first, let's try to repair this thread. And then I'll try to find the missing bolts on this, and we'll repair these grips. I'll show you what I use that works really, really well. And then lastly, we'll paint it up and make it look nice. We'll paint this flat black, and we'll paint this. I think I have some semi-gloss black for this part. Hopefully, if I can find a screw, I might have to paint the top black to match the other one. It's not that super important, but you know, finding this little lock bolt here, this basically locks the focuser tube at one position. That might be a little bit tricky because this is a metallic bolt that has a soft nylon end, so it doesn't scratch up the focuser tube. So we'll see what happens. All right, so let's take a close look at this. There's quite a bit of damage on these threads. I have this really sharp file. It comes to almost a knife edge. And I'm just going to basically run it through here and try to get it to a point where it'll screw into here. The threads on the tube, amazingly enough, look fantastic. These threads are really good. They look great. So this is the one this is the part that's gotten all the damage. I think this is aluminum. It's super lightweight. So let's try to put this in here and try to get rid of all these nicks. All right, so I'm just going to gently try to file these out. It's these starting threads right here that are really bad. Part of me wonders if I should just sand off the first 16th of an inch here, but I'm going to try to recover these threads. Okay, so that was the trick. I didn't have to buy one of the expensive thread fix files. I just used this one that has a really sharp knife edge. It's a hobby file. It comes in a set. It's a set of files. So I'll put a link to those down in the description box below. All right, that part seems fixed.
Hello, if you're enjoying this video, then push that like button. It means the world to little channels like this.
Okay, since I have this close-up view, let's go ahead and take this apart. All right. Here is the axle. It's missing the rubber grips, and we'll clean this up a little bit. It's quite greasy. As you rotate this axle, it causes the tube to go in and out. And of course, it's pushing against these roller bearings right there. There's four roller bearings. Now, again, I have a whole video on the history of this. So, okay, so the missing rubber grips. As far as I can tell, you can't buy the originals. This is what they look like. It's these rubber grips right there. You can't really buy those. Uh-oh, this has a little bit of a bend to it. It looks like somebody pushed really hard on this. I'll try to straighten that out. Shouldn't cause too much of a problem. But here's how I fix it. I have these silicone O-rings, and they're 1.25 inches on the inside diameter. And these are really cheap. I think they're $7 or $8. I always have some of these around. Let's go ahead and fix it right now. They just go over the end like this. And I believe 4 of them will fit. And if they do, if they rotate, they can sort of unroll their way towards the edge. So I try to not do that if I can. There you go. That's what they look like. They're super grippy, and I've had these on my main 8-inch Dobsonian for a long time, and they work really, really well. Now I'll just do the same to the other side, and we'll be done. All right. So let's call this part done. I'm going to clean this up. And if this slight bend in the axle gives me any trouble, I'll go ahead and straighten it out. One word of caution, this axle is bent. So you have to unscrew these set screws. There's one on each side and they just pull out. And you put it in your vise. The bend is very, very slight. And then I pull. Now I can't get it perfect, but you really want to try to get it perfect because you don't want this wobbling around as it's pushed against the focuser tube. So I'll put this back on here. I have to tighten that set screw. And that set screw will be good as new. So let's go ahead and call this done. Now here's that back plate that I was telling you about. And this center set screw pushes on this little friction block right here. Oop. And this pushes in and out against the tube, and it adjusts the friction on the focuser tube to your desired amount of tension. And unfortunately, this thing, it seems to, they glued it in place. So I'm going to be basically just doing a quick cleaning on this, and I'm just going to scrub it with some alcohol and try to get it clean, but shouldn't be too bad. Okay, so what's the status that we have now? Well, we have the tube, and it's all repaired, except it needs to be painted. It's not a problem. We have the axle for the Crayford focuser. This is all cleaned up and degreased. It had some super sticky grease on here. I also straightened the axle. The back plate and the friction block, I had to remove the goopy tape that was on here. It was basically making this super impossible to modify. And now this is all clean and it fits in there like a glove. So what do we need to do now? So we need to find a fourth one of these screws. These hold the back plate on. I only have three of them. And I need to find something that I can use. It's got to be a 5mm thread that goes in here and has a soft end. So I'm going to look through my collection of nylon bolts and we'll see what we can do. And the one we're looking for is 3mm. So let's start looking. Fixed a lot of Crayford focusers, so there's probably one in here. That looks like a pretty good candidate, actually. Put that right there. I don't know if that's threaded all the way up. Here's one. It's not black anymore. That's also the same. And that looks like the exact same size head. Pretty similar. All right, so we've got two good candidates. I'll see which one works better, and I'll paint it black. Now we need to find a 5mm, one that's nylon. Now we're not going to find one that is metal with nylon in this pile, so I'm going to have to find just a nylon one from my other stockpile. So let's try that. So this is the Tinker Crate. I don't know if your kids ever use these, but they use the heck out of them. And when my kids are done with them, I never really throw them away. I just take them apart and get all the parts off of them. These are a great supply of metric screws, especially soft nylon ones. So here we go, something like this. That is probably 5mm. That's 5mm. All right, let's see if this screws into the back plate. It does. It's not very grippy. I'm going to keep looking through here and see if I can find one with a bigger head on it that'll be easier to grip. But in the worst case, I'll use this if I can't find anything else. All right, I think we're good to go now. Okay, so here's what I found. I found this guy. This is 5mm, and it's got a big knurled head, and it's soft nylon plastic or something like that, and it's going to work great. The threads didn't go all the way up, so I actually had to use a 5mm die to basically complete the threads. But this screws in right there just fine, and it's going to make it really easy to use. I had to use this one for the 3mm, and I ran into a problem in that the hole that it's supposed to go into, I guess over the years, different threaded parts have gone in there, and the threads are mangled. So I have to tap that out with the 3mm tap. Unfortunately, I have one, so I'm just going to go ahead and fix that. Yeah.
All right, so I've gone ahead and painted some of the parts. The first thing I'll talk about is the focuser tube. I used an ultra flat finish on this, and it works really well. It's my choice of paint, and that is the Rust-Oleum Camouflage. It's called the Ultra Flat Colors. They say it's non-reflective, and it really is. It's not reflective at all. It has a very, very matte finish on it. And the best part about it is you can buy this at Walmart. For the focuser ring, which turned out really well, and the head of the screws, I used semi-gloss, which I think is the best way to match the reflectivity of the main body of the Crayford focuser. And for that, I just used Rust-Oleum. It's a paint plus primer semi-gloss. I found these two paints to be pretty hardy, and they don't flake off or anything like that. Before we reassemble it, we're going to need to remove the mask tape from this. So let's find the edge. Then we've got these three strips right here. This reveals the flat part that the Crayford axle runs on. And then we've got the two bearing surfaces. And here's the last one. All right. So it's time to reassemble. Now you're more than welcome to assemble this any way you would like, but I'm going to show you the safest way to do this to cause the least amount of damage. The first thing I would recommend is take this back plate, make sure your block is in there, and pull the set screw out just a little bit, because we've already had to go to the trouble of straightening a bent axle, and the last thing you want to do is screw this down with too much tension already dialed in and cause the axle to bend again. So unscrew this a little bit. Now the next step is to take the 2-inch adapter ring and screw this very carefully into the focuser tube. Make sure you don't cross thread it. Now we take the Crayford focuser body, and I've got a little spacer here, and we're going to feed this in with the flat side up. We're going to do this very carefully without scraping any of the paint off. And we take the axle, and we take that back plate, put them together like this, very carefully, and we set this in. Yeah. Now, of course, it's very, very loose right now. Let's put the screws in. Because we've removed a lot of the tension with the center tension bolt, we can screw these down tight. This is clearly too loose, so we're going to adjust the tension screw. Keep turning it until you feel that little bit of tension. All right. Now try it. That's looking pretty good. Can you move it? If you can't move it, that's a pretty good sign. Go to the full extension all the way out and go all the way in. If you see any slippage, you can just adjust it in tiny little bits. All done.
Well, here is the repaired Crayford focuser looking better than new. I mean, look, it's got these cool red grips. Isn't that neat? I think it's pretty cool. I'll be sending this back to Mark later this week, and I look forward to hearing about all the cool stuff that he's going to see with his newly refurbished Dobsonian telescope. If you want to know why it's called a Crayford focuser, well, click on this video over here. I'll give you a hint. It's not named after a person, but we do have it because of the generosity of a person. Go ahead. I think you'll like this video. Many thanks to Mark for letting me work on this, and thank all of you for watching the video. Clear skies, everybody.